Hello everyone, Omar is here. Today we are checking out this fancy PCI to AGP adapter from SDZmods.com. To make things more interesting, we are going to test some AGP cards on an Intel 13th gen configuration while running Windows 98 and Windows XP, just to check what could possibly go wrong. I have to mention that SDZ-mods.com is not selling any hardware, so this must be the best PCI to AGP adapter you can actually buy. However, if you really want one, Daniel, who designed this adapter, published on SDZ-mods all the necessary files and schematics. So theoretically, you can make as many adapters as you want if you know how to fill an order on a site like PCB Way. Luckily for me, Daniel was kind enough to send me a finished adapter, and not only this adapter, but also two gorgeous Voodoo 1 cards with HDMI output and extra memory, which will be featured on a future special video. Now let's go back to this fancy, a bit over-engineered PCI to AGP adapter. First of all, how these adapters work. Well, to oversimplify things, let's say that an AGP slot, it's a double-speed PCI slot. Of course, this is not the whole story behind the accelerated graphics port, which is actually a more sophisticated standard, but in the same time, an AGP card can also work like a PCI card. And this was actually the case when the first AGP cards were released back in 1997, when all the graphics chips were designed around the PCI bus. So many first generation AGP cards were basically PCI cards with an AGP connector. And that's why early benchmarks showed that many AGP cards perform almost exactly the same as their PCI variants. Now that we know, it's not that complicated to bring some AGP cards back to their PCI roots. Let's do some testing on my multi-boot 13th gen configuration where Windows 98, Windows XP and Windows 11 are doing a ménage à trois on the same NVMe SSD. As with any other slot adapter, our card will increase to a non-standard size. With low-profile cards, we may get away, but with a full-height card, depending on how the VGA connector gets shifted, we may not be able to install the card at all on a standard case. So let's do the testing outside the case, starting with a classic AGP Voodoo 3 2000 manufactured by STB, a company which was acquired by 3DFX in late 1998. Voodoo cards are known to work with PCI adapters, especially because 3DFX didn't care much about AGP features. Actually, there are some AGP to PCI adapters made for specifically for Voodoo cards that are not using any electronic components. There is just a plain pin by pin AGP to PCI conversion. According to Daniel from SDZ Mods, which obviously knows his stuff, these adapters are quite dodgy and possible unstable, and may kill some chips when used in older 5-volt only PCI slots. Now, going back to our configuration, this Voodoo 3 2000 AGP card simply works normally in Windows XP. For example, Test Drive 5 works and looks pretty good when rendered with 3DFX Glide API. Some older games won't work with 3DFX drivers in Windows XP without some extra tweaking. Need for Speed 2 Special Edition looks like it's one of those games, no problem. All it takes to run Windows 98 on this configuration, it's a reboot, so let's run Need for Speed from there. this time using official 3DFX drivers. Now you are seeing a 640 by 480 resolution upscaled to full HD. It may look a bit washed out, but you have to believe me that back in 1998, this game and especially this level looks so amazing on a CRT monitor. One of the benefits of this adapter is that we can test some crappy AGP cards too. Like this 4 MB S3 Trio 3D 2X card, which is not much of a 3D accelerator, but at least has a nice control panel. Anyway, some direct 3D games will run on this Trio 3D 2X, and Test Drive 5 is one of them. We saw earlier that Test Drive 5 look way better on a Voodoo, but it's not that bad on this S3. In the same time, other Direct3D games will render like this. And believe me, it's not the adapter's fault. Another not so great AGP card that works is this ATI Rage 2C from 1998. Windows XP has drivers for it. I didn't have to install anything. And this is how Half-Life will render under Direct3D. Way better than the previous S3 Trio 3D card, but still not quite there. Now let's talk about cards that won't work at all with this adapter. A last generation and newer 1.5 volts only AGP cards won't physically fit, so we don't have to worry about them. They won't work. So only cards with a universal connector and first generation AGP cards can theoretically work. I tested a GeForce 2 Ti, a GeForce 2 MX, and a TNT 2 Ultra, and none of these Nvidia cards showed anything on the screen. However, according to SDZmods.com, older TNT cards are known to work. So right about when I was convinced that newer AGP cards won't work, I checked this AGP 8X's Zaber or Shaber 400. This is a mid-range GPU from 2002 with hardware transform and lightning, and it's comparable with a Nvidia GeForce 4MX. It was competitively priced back then, but now if you want one, they are quite expensive. Well, what can I say? The drivers are installing without any issues, and it looks like this AGP 8X card just works perfectly fine. Obviously, this card would have been a better performer on an actual AGP 8X slot, but even so, on a slow PCI slot, we get by far the best scores in Quake 3. Well, this SIS card was a nice surprise. I have to check this AGP adapter on some other motherboards. I know for sure that this ASUS 610 motherboard that I have is quite picky about video cards. I have even some older PCI Express cards that won't post with this motherboard. So it is possible to discover more compatible AGP cards with more testing. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned for the next video.